big E.
In the barber's chair this week, it's Demis Roussos.
So tell me, what was it the first number one you had in the world? What made you famous?
Well, the Rain and Tears was really the song that made the band famous, Aphrodite's Child. But as a solo career, you know, forever and ever, everybody knows. In this country, it sold a lot of records.
Can you sing just a little bit of the tune?
No, I don't.
No? What can you sing so you can revive a little bit of people's memory? Just something, was it Rain?
I don't have to revive them, they know who I am.
No, but they know, but I think it'd be nice, just for...
If they want to revive...
To have Demis Roussos on the big E, singing just a little tune.
Well, if they want to revive their memory, they can buy my record.
Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be the one that shines on me like the morning sun. Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be my spring, my rainbow's end, and the song.
Are you involved in any of the musical arrangement? Don't worry, your hair's still here.
Yeah.
It's still there. I was only trimming the ends.
Yeah.
So were you involved in the musical arrangement?
Yes, very much.
Yeah?
Very much.
And you
very
still
much.
Worried about your hair?
Yeah.
Can I show you?
Yeah.
Can I show you?
It's wonderful. Oh, you did a good job.
You see, it's still there, so don't worry.
Yeah, the French taste there.
Yeah, yeah. But tell me, in all of the song, there's lots of melody and everything. Are you a very, very sad person?
Sad?
Yeah.
No, I don't think I'm sad. I'm Mediterranean.
I mean, you can be Mediterranean and being sad. I mean...
No, I don't think I'm sad. I'm sensitive.
You're sensitive?
Yes, I like the good things in life.
For instance?
Well, I like good music, I like a beautiful woman, I like...
Oh, like me? Yeah, I think like a lot of people. Yeah, what else?
I like, a good dinner, good wine.
Good wine, very important, yeah?
And is your French thing coming up again?
Are you a womanizer? Yeah. You've been surrounded in your past 20 years since you've been a star by a lot of women?
Yeah, I mean, a lot. You know, with fair amount.
Yeah, I mean, you don't read about Demis Roussos breaking a woman's heart and, you know, like stories of a love child in America or in Greece or in Italy.
No, I don't think I ever had this.
No?
I'm not this kind of...
Well, you don't know. I mean, you only need to do it once.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
In the, was it 10, 15 years ago, you had a lucky escape where you were hijacked and kidnapped.
Mm.
Yeah? What happened? Could you tell me more about it?
No, I cannot tell you more about it because it's something I don't want to talk about. It. The only thing I can tell you is that I was very lucky.
You're lucky. But was it easy for you because you spoke the language?
Maybe.
Yeah?
Maybe it was easy for me because they knew I wasn't involved with any political things. And, if they kidnap journalists and things like that, it's because sometimes journalists are spying a little bit, you know.
They give information.
Yeah, they give information, so they think that they are spies and things. But for a singer, I don't think this is the case. And on the other hand, they didn't kidnap me because they planned it. You know, I wasn't planning that.
So. It was just. But tell me, after the kidnapping, you came out and everything, and for about 5 years, nobody heard anything about you. Is that the shock? It was like to go into semi-retirement because you think, my God, it's my second life now. I should have been dead.
I never thought about it this way.
No,
the other thing that I have to tell you is that in this country, people didn't hear about me because I didn't release any records.